Rolling Stone fucking hate. They fucking hate Chris D'Elia, man. It's so funny. It's courtesy of Rolling Stone. Look at this fucking headline. Disgraced comedian. Get a child away here. Disgraced comedians are looking for a second chance on Friends. And they got a picture of Dane Cook and Chris D'Elia. They fucking hate him. It's so good how much they're going on Chris. But it's just fucking brutal. It says Friends, a brand new social app from Instagram that bears more than a passing resemblance to Twitter, has already pulled in a massive user base, notching up to 50 million signups in just a day after launch. Fucking hell. The Silicon Valley shakeup is exasperating tensions between Elon Musk and Mark Zuckerberg, with attorneys and former already arguing that the Instagram parent Meta hired dozens of former Twitter employees and misappropriated its trade secrets to develop the rival app. But while the tech giants duke it out for the privilege of extracting our personal data, a handful of stand-up comedians who have faced some level of cancellation fueled by internet outrage set up shop on Threads, apparently finding it a safe harbor for now. Okay, I'm on Threads, wrote Chris D'Elia on Wednesday. After joining the Instagram-enabled tech service, he filled up his first post with a link to his website, writing that tour dates are available there. In a recent Rolling Stone report, 10 women came forward to accuse D'Elia of emotional and sexual predatory behavior. Some were teenagers when they alleged, Jesus Christ, this fucking paragraph, unsettling encounters with the comedian. The FBI conducted interviews with the accusers, but Chris D'Elia continues to deny the claims. D'Elia, known from TV shows like Whitney and You. Oh, go away, please. Can I not get this off here? Don't want to shop. Is it going to make me shop? Okay, there you go, X there. Known for Whitney and You, has not posted on Twitter since the summer of 2020. Because he keeps getting ratioed and they keep attacking him, obviously. You know, he's attacking me. They're attacking me. When the site was flooded with anonymous accounts of dozens of women who allegedly had... he had groomed them. Sorry, fucking hell, what? I can't speak here. D'Elia, known from TV shows, including Whitney and You, has not posted on Twitter since the summer of 2020, when the site was flooded with anonymous accounts from dozens of women who alleged that he had groomed them, solicited them for nude photos, and made unwanted sexual advances when they were underage. D'Elia denied the allegations as well. On Threads, however, he already has more than 73,000 followers, possibly boosted in part because newcomers have the option to mass follow everyone they follow on Instagram, where D'Elia maintains an audience of 2.2 million. While he has been the target of some mockery from hostile Threads who bring up the abuse allegations, many of the replies to D'Elia of early posts have been welcoming and positive. Shortly after he appeared on the app, one fan wrote, "Now it feels like home." Gross. Tour dates. Okay, I'm on Threads. Two stand-up comedians who made it big in TV but saw their careers take a hit when they were accused of professional conduct have also migrated. So Threads is becoming the home of all the cancelled guys to kind of spread positivity. Because one thing I kind of do like about Instagram, to be completely fair, it is very separate, the audiences. So if you get a lot of hate on Twitter, usually it doesn't transfer over to Instagram. It kind of is platform specific. So if you get trolled and hated on Instagram, it's not going to go Twitter and vice versa. So that's pretty decent. So if you are a predator, if you are a pedo, if you are a rapist, maybe if you want to seek refuge somewhere, weirdly enough, even though Meta is very, very, you know, they're super hardcore when it comes to censorship, you know, Mark Zuckerberg and shit, right? They can ban your accounts. They fucking ban OnlyFans girls on there a lot for putting links on their fucking bio. They're very, very strict over there. Still, if you're a pedo, if you're an abuser and shit, you can get away with a lot. You know what I mean? You can get away with a lot. You can have your own little new career, a new lease of life over there. So this makes a lot of sense. Mencia's Comedy Central show, Mind of Mencia, came on at the end of 2008, after lesser known comic Joe Rogan went viral with a video in which he confronted Mencia on stage for allegedly plagiarizing jokes. The footage is cut together with footage of purporting to show Mencia performing material written and used by other comedians first. It's ironic that a guy who is now saying you shouldn't cancel anybody at least started the building of his podcast by canceling me, said Mencia of Rogan in an interview years later. Jesus Christ. That's a pretty interesting comment though to make. That's very accurate, but it's also coming from the wrong person, right? Sometimes the right thing is said by the wrong person. But he does make a good point here. It's ironic that the guy who is now saying you shouldn't cancel anybody at least played a part in building his podcast by cancelling me. Oof. While he didn't immediately gain a follower count by like the Leahs, Mencia started on a optimistic note as he tested out Fred's, writing, hopefully this isn't as toxic as Twitter. Mencia has an account on Twitter but has not been active on that platform. I love how no one wants to be active on Twitter because Twitter is fundamentally very mean, but also it's not very kind to people who are, you know, portrayed as villains. They always remind you that you're a villain on there. So you have to have a lot of thick, you have to have very, very thick skin to survive on there. Hopefully this isn't as toxic as Twitter. Ben C has an account on Twitter, but is not active on the platform. He set about promoting his upcoming shows and appearances on Fred. He says, go on Good Morning. Wait, about to go on Good Morning Arizona. Jesus Christ, bro. How mighty have fallen. You're promoting a Good Morning Arizona. Okay, hopefully this isn't as toxic as Twitter. DeGeneres meanwhile had no problems quickly amassing 1.5 million. Jesus Christ, putting her within range of Zuckerberg himself, who currently has 2.3. in an inaugural post, she cheerfully declared Fred to be the gay Twitter, drawing manner of distinction between Musk-owned app. DeGeneres seems to be abandoned her Twitter account in April of this year, leaving it dormant since. DeGeneres announced the end of her once mega popular daytime talk program in 2021 amid rating slump after BuzzFeed News reports allegation from former and current employees that she oversaw a toxic workplace despite her being kind mantra. Last fall, singer Grayson Chance, who appeared on DeGeneres' show in 2010 as a 12-year-old star, became the first act she signed on a now defunct record label, spoke about his experiences with the former daytime host. Chance claimed that she had become harshly controlling over his music career and then abandoned him when one of his records underperformed. I've never met someone more manipulative, self-centered, and more blatantly opportunistic than her. Jesus Christos. But now embattled comedians have embraced it, such as Dane Cook, an A-lister in the mid-aughts who sold out arenas and went double platinum in 2005. With his live album called Retaliation. Between some Hollywood flops and onstage misogyny, Taser's comments about mass shooting and his own plagiarized scandals, critics believe he stole material. And from the also accounts of Louis C.K., Rogan accused him of joke fest as well. His stardom failed. Is that why it failed? His career failed because he had some terrible movies. He would display he was a bit misogynistic on stage, a little bit of an early Andrew Tate. And because of Taser's comments about mass shootings. Is that all that kind of cost him his career? Crazy, isn't it? He was super big at one time. Cook did his iffy reputation no favors last summer when, at the age of 50, he revealed that he was engaged to his 23-year-old girlfriend, Kelsey Taylor. That's no problem. Leonardo DiCaprio dates girls like that as well. Like, let's be a bit fair in that regard. It's a bit disgusting, I know, optics-wise, but it kind of is what it is. Two grown adults, let them do what they want to do. It's none of our business. Internet sleuths quickly figured out Cook had known Taylor since she was 17. Okay, now it gets dicey. Yo. And attended Cook's games nights, which were frequented by underage girls as well as adults. Dicey, dicey indeed. That timeline and the eyebrow-raising age gap between Cook and Taylor had Twitter users branding him a groomer. On Fred's, however, Cook is quite at home, alternating between jokes and showbiz stories and attempts at inspirational life advice. So are they trying to paint Fred's as being the home of fucking like pedos, groomers, workplace abusers, rapists and shit? That's an interesting way to paint it, considering it's owned by Meta, to be fair, who are legitimately one of the most strictest platforms out there in terms of banning people for that sort of stuff on Facebook and Instagram. But hey, everyone deserves to be treated like an equal. He posted at one point elsewhere, musing, maybe your sole purpose in life is not to have one, but many at many times with others. What? What kind of quote is that? Maybe your sole purpose in life is not to have one, but many at many times with many others. While hashtags do not function on the app as they do on Twitter, love life, it loves you back, to a photo of himself in a pool. He has even expressed the notion that Fred's is a healing foundation, a utopian sanctuary. These entertainers are fucking redax. They are super, super redacted. Can you imagine how redacted you must be? to go on a fucking platform hoping that it's going to bring you some level of spiritual healing. It's going to be a utopia for you. It's going to be a place where you can be not judged and like grow up, brother. You're 50 years old. Like, grow the fuck up. It's the fucking internet. It's the wild, wild west. People say horrible things to each other every single time on you because you can. It kind of is the nature of the beast. Like, fucking hell. Please, fix skin immediately. Picture of him and Dane. He's poor. The house looks fucking good, though, to be fair. Dating underage girls and being a bit of a groomer definitely pays. The house looks fucking beautiful. Let's not lie about that. It's continuing there. It says, what does it say here? Fred's day three impression. Community is lively. Many offering food or comfort. How they offering you food through a fucking text-based app? You fucking donkey. Food. Is he actually talking about figuratively food or metaphorically food? Or is he talking about, like, is food like some sort of euphemism for, like, I don't know, young snatch or some shit. I don't know. Who knows? Whatever it is, I don't want any part of it. Seems like Fred's is a healing foundation. Less people trying to steal thunder. More trying to lend a helping hand or words of wisdom. You don't want words of wisdom from random people. We want to buy your tickets, buy your merch and come to your shows. Stop with this shit. Some random person in the middle of the country giving you advice in your career, you're not going to listen to them. You're going to treat them like a peon because you think you're better than them. Let's not lie. Words of wisdom. Lols. It's like a slice of utopia built on this false hope highway of disinformation and bias based on projecting past trauma on those currently thriving and shining. Are you having a laugh? What? So people that are criticizing you have got past trauma that they're dealing with and they're projecting it on you because you're thriving and shining. They hate me because I'm too good, right? That famous Cristiano Ronaldo quote. Maybe they hate me because I'm too good. I might actually have fun today. I'm going to edit my doc, swim, then come back here and pal around. Okay, bro. Nice to know that. Don't tell us again. Reps for Cook, Daenerys. DeGeneres, I'm calling her Daenerys from Game of Thrones. DeGeneres and Mencia did not respond for a request for comment as to whether the comedian's clients see an advent of Fred's as an opportunity to rebrand. Yeah, right. They didn't want to ask him that. They wanted to ask him something more spicy. A comedy promoter reportedly managing D'Elia as of last year likewise did not respond to questions of what he hopes to achieve on the app. Okay, so that person's on there as well. That guy that was like smiling and laughing about the girls that were... No smiling, laughing. He was kind of, I don't know, he came across a bit slimy. The former manager dude. So he's on Fred's also. Brian Callan's probably on Fred's as well, I'm assuming, right? Nevertheless, the emerging pattern hints that the entertainers dogged by negative press views Fred as a friendlier platform. Far away from the mob of detractors on Twitter. Oh, look, there's that word that DSP always uses, detractors. Who would continue to dredge up serious allegations and embarrassing headlines. Perhaps the millions flocking to the Instagram platform this week will prove themselves eager to forget celebrities' past missteps or misconducts and Cook's turn from frat bro humor towards a more wholesome stick sounds especially deliberate. I'm saying whatever I want to say. I've never said it before, reads his Twitter bio. Fred's bio, sorry. Whatever the coming weeks and months hold for this bubbling scene, one thing's for sure, Musk declaring that comedy is now legal on Twitter wasn't enough to convince him to comics to stay. Okay, so Fred's is now the home of Dane Cook and Chris D'Elia. If you want that kind of community, if that's people you want to associate with, then enjoy Fred's. I opened up an account. I downloaded the app to see what it's like. Took a gander. Wasn't for me. Haven't opened it since. Because I am not a diddler and or a groomer. So I don't want to be there with those guys. But no, mostly because I just use Twitter anyway. I don't really care about what these guys do on these platforms. I just, you know, there has to be a limit about how many apps you're meant to be using in one day. Especially as a grown up, man. But anyway, let me quickly get a water and a tissue. Bear with me 1 second as I blow. Okay. So, yeah, exactly. People saying in chat, was it? I can't do it. Apps at this age. Is Instagram cool? I don't even know. Is Instagram cool? Probably, because there's still Instagram is still the one place where you have like a good portion of like millennials and Gen Z people, and they're typically the cooler people in society and culture now. So that's why most of them hang around on Instagram. So because of that, it's probably still cool, and it probably still a good platform to kind of find out news and whatever. Maybe it's kind of like a good one stop shop, but there comes a point where if you're like, there was a point where I was on all social media apps, I was on everything, but I was on everything and actively using it. Then there comes a point where there's so much of your attention is being split all between these different apps. You just have to focus in on the ones you actually use. And the ones I use mostly day to day, because I count Reddit as a social media platform, I probably use Twitter and Reddit the most. And then Instagram maybe third. But those are the main two that I use. So there's no real point me getting or really using Blue Sky or using Truth Social or using Snapchat or TikTok aggressively, because I don't have the capacity, the RAM space, you know, on my computer or my fucking brain to be able to have all those apps balancing at one time. It's just too much, man. I can't be doing it, really. I'd rather just chill, you know, basically. I'd rather just chill and just concentrate on the things I need to concentrate on. There's too much stuff out there, man. And included in that, I kind of read a lot of books. I watch a lot of movies, documentaries, TV shows, YouTube. There's just too much stuff that I'm already consuming content-wise. How much more can I kind of carve out in my day to go on the other apps? It's just too much. Just simply too much. So I'd rather just stick to what I'm currently doing. Maybe the wrong thing to do. Who knows? But I think for now, it's probably the best.